Hi, I'm Amy of Amy Nicole Floral, and on today's episode, I'm going to be talking all about how to use a floral knife. A floral knife is a very sharp, smallish knife that allows you to work with your hand very quickly in cutting and processing stems while you're designing. So one of the reasons that I really prefer to use a floral knife is it's very ergonomically safe. I'm not opening and closing my hand like I do with clippers. It's also very fast. I'm able to very quickly pare down a stem, make a fresh cut, place it into a design without needing to set it back on the table for every single cut. So it's also very helpful in making a very clean, sharp cut. If I am using a pair of clippers that isn't quite sharp enough, I can pinch or damage the stem, which can inhibit water from being taken up by the stem. So when you use a floral knife, it really allows that stem to drink more easily and prevents it from collapsing in any area. Similar to, again, how clippers can do that. So I'm gonna show you today how to use a floral knife. It can be a little bit intimidating, I think, especially when you first start you working with flowers, in holding a flower knife properly. And that's what I wanna teach you how to do today. So some of the flower knives that are available, and that some of my favorite ones, are made by a company called Victorinox, and I will link this in my video below for you. There's a straight edge knife here, and I always like to put my initials on them just in case, because they get mixed up among sometimes other people's if you're working with lots of other people. There's also this hooked option, and this is really nice because the edge of that really kind of holds that stem in place and allows you to really cut larger stems a lot more easily. And then there's this kind of more inexpensive Klaus brand that is great to just have several of these around. It does work fine. It's definitely not as strong. It's a very thin plastic, and I prefer sort of the stronger casing. It feels a little bit more sturdy in my hand when I'm working with it. So I'm going to demonstrate for you how to make a safe and effective cut using a floral knife. So if you're right-handed like I am, I take the knife in my hand with the blade facing me, and this can seem very intimidating because you have this sharp blade facing your thumb, but you will never cut yourself if you maintain and think about having this little square that's always between you and the knife. So if you think about this little square, your finger is really supporting the stem, the knife is turned at a slight 45 degree angle, and you're pushing pressure into the blade. So I'm not overworking the knife. I'm really using my other hand and the stem, and it's a joint action. It's this motion right here. So you can practice this with some leftovers, some stems from your yard, but you're really using your thumb to put pressure on this end. The knife blade is at an angle, and you're pulling the stem away from your body. If you want to see this from a side angle, I'm really just, this motion right here is the motion that is allowing this to be the most beneficial and to make the fastest cut. As you become more proficient with a knife, you will find that you never put it down, that you simply are cutting, shaving things down, that you're quickly and easily able to use it. I will lift things out of buckets with it in my hand. In many, many years, have never cut myself using it doing flowers. So as long as you are maintaining that little square, you're never gonna cut yourself. This is really an efficient way to design. And I find that over the years of using clippers, you can really develop some problems in your wrist and arm. So buy yourself a floral knife. Confront your fears if you have any, and go out there and practice this method. Again, it takes a little time to get used to, but maintaining that strength in your hand, practicing that motion, I'm sure you'll have it in no time. So this information's been helpful. Make sure to, of course, like this video, share it with your flower-loving friends, and of course, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of the new content coming your way. Thank you so much for watching.